Amplifier. What is the basic definition of the amplifier? Means if you increase, so small signal if you apply, so here that increases the signal strength, voltage level, so that will be increases. Voltage level that will be increased. So how to classify? So how to classify the amplifier? Means so first one is frequency range. First one is frequency range. Okay. So depending upon frequency range, so the amplifiers are classified. So depending upon the frequency range, mein, for example here, frequency is zero means, so this type of amplifiers are called DC amplifiers. Frequency is zero means, so this type of amplifiers are called DC amplifiers. Frequency is zero means, so here nothing but a frequency is zero. Okay, there is no frequency. If it is frequency zero means, so this type of amplifiers are called DC amplifiers. So this type of amplifiers are called DC amplifiers. So that is the frequency. For example here, next here frequency range is 20 Hz to 20 kHz. Frequency range is 20 Hz to 20 kHz. So in this frequency range, so these amplifiers are called audio amplifiers. So these amplifiers are called audio amplifiers. Depending upon frequency range, if it is frequency 0 means that amplifiers are called DC amplifiers. If it is frequency range 20 Hz to 20 kHz means, so here in this range of amplifiers are called audio amplifiers. So if it is frequency range is up to megahertz. So these amplifiers are called video amplifiers. So these amplifiers are called video amplifiers. If it is frequency 0, DC amplifiers. If it is frequency in between, so 20 Hz to 20 kHz means audio amplifier. Frequency up to megahertz. Megahertz means, so that amplifiers are called video amplifiers. So depending upon frequency range, so here we classify the amplifiers. So next one is method of coupling. So method of coupling means, so one stage to the other stage. For example here method of coupling means, so three types of method of coupling. So here RC coupling, okay, RC coupling, transformer coupling, transformer coupling, direct coupling. So three types of coupling methods are there. So in this one, three types of coupling methods also here we can classify the amplifiers. For example, here one stage to the other stage. So this is nothing but amplifier one stage. So one stage, for example, if you are connected capacitor and resistor, so this type of amplifier is called RC coupled amplifier. So this type of amplifier is called RC coupled amplifier. So coupling between one stage to the other stage. If it is capacitor with a resistor coupled with one stage to the other stage means, so that coupling is called, which type of amplifier means, that is RC coupled amplifier. That is RC coupled amplifier. One stage to the other stage. So now here in between, so coupling with transformer. So I am coupling with, so here it is transformer. One stage to the other stage, so coupled with transformer. So coupling with the transformer means, so this type of amplifier is called transformer coupled amplifier. So transformer coupled amplifier. So why we are connecting this transformer coupled amplifier means, so here impedance matching purpose. So this transformer coupled we are using. Coupling, three different techniques, RC coupling, transformer coupling and direct coupling. So impedance matching purpose, so here this coupling is used. So where this is used in means, so in power amplifiers. In power amplifier, if you want to match one stage to the other stage, so from source to the load, so here transformer is used. Next, last one is direct coupling. So direct coupling. So how to couple the one stage to the other stage without any without any components, without resistor, without capacitor, without transformer, directly one stage to the other stage, directly you have to connect. Here there is no capacitor, there is no resistor, nothing, transformer, nothing will be there. So there is no capacitor and resistor, transformer means, so here DC, so here it does not block the DC. So that is the disadvantage of the direct coupling. So here if any DC is there, so that is directly entering into the next stage of the amplifier. So that is the disadvantage of the direct coupling amplifier. So that is direct, if it is directly coupled means that is directly coupled amplifier. So depending upon the frequency range, depending upon the method of coupling, so here we can classify the amplifier. So third one is depending upon applications. Okay. Depending upon application. If it is the amplifier's voltage. If the amplifier amplifies the voltage, so that amplifier is called voltage amplifier. That amplifier is called voltage amplifier. Depending upon applications also. If it is the amplifier amplifies current, so that amplifier is called current amplifier. And amplifies. Okay. If it is, it amplifies both voltage and current, so that amplifiers are called power amplifiers. That amplifiers are called power amplifiers. Okay. Tuned amplifiers. So here, tuned amplifiers. Tuned amplifier means, so it selects the particular frequency, it amplifies only on that particular frequency only. So that amplifiers are called tuned amplifiers. So that amplifiers are called tuned amplifier. So depending upon application, so we can classify the amplifiers: voltage amplifier, current amplifier, power amplifier, okay, tuned amplifier. So these are the different types of amplifiers. So using method of coupling also, here we can classify the amplifier: RC coupled amplifier, transformer coupling, so direct coupling amplifier. So these are the classifications of amplifiers. Next one is amplifiers. What are the basic amplifier means? Common emitter amplifiers, emitter follower amplifier, another name is common collector amplifier. So next one is common base amplifier. So we will see one by one. First amplifier is, basic amplifier is common emitter amplifier. Common emitter amplifier. Previously we have classified the amplifiers depending upon frequency range, depending upon method of coupling, depending upon application, so we classified the amplifier. So next basic amplifiers are here. First one is common emitter amplifier. So common emitter amplifier. What is the circuit diagram of the common emitter amplifier? This is a common emitter amplifier. So common emitter amplifier. So what are the major components of the common emitter amplifier? So here bypass capacitor is there, so emitter resistor is there. So here this is nothing but a collector resistance, so coupling capacitor. So what is the use of this? This is nothing but a CV, blocking capacitor. So this is coupling capacitor. What is the uses of the blocking capacitor and coupling capacitor? What is the uses of the blocking capacitor and coupling capacitor? So what is the uses means? This blocking capacitor blocks the DC, it allows only AC signal, it allows only AC. For example, in the circuit, so that will be any DC is there, we are amplifying only AC signal. For example, here we are giving AC signal. So here the common emitter amplifier output is 180 degrees phase shift. The common emitter amplifier output is 180 degrees phase shift. Why 180 degrees phase shift? I will explain. So what is the use of the blocking capacitor and coupling capacitor? So that blocks the DC, it allows only AC signal. So this is also coupling capacitor. If you want to connect one more stage, one more stage means, so here if any DC is there, that blocks the DC, it allows only AC signal. So that is the uses of the blocking capacitor and so coupling capacitor. What is the use of the R1, R2 and RE? RC. What is the uses of the, this one means? So this R1 resistor, R2 resistor, so this RE resistor. RE resistor used for stabilization purpose. RE resistor is used for stabilization purpose. Stabilization purpose means, so if you want the circuit is stable, so that's why you have to maintain stable, so this RE resistor is used. So next one is coupling emitter bypass capacitor. What is the use of the emitter bypass capacitor? For example, here emitter bypass capacitor is not there. So here emitter bypass capacitor is not there. The amplified AC signal flows through this resistor. Whenever here a signal is flows through this resistor means, so here the voltage drop will be occur. The voltage drop will be occur means automatically output voltage is reduces. So that's why I am connecting. So emitter bypass capacitor. The amplified AC signal flows through the in this path, low reactance path. It chooses the here low reactance path. So here there is no effect on the voltage level. So that is the advantage of the here this bypass capacitor. So coupling capacitor, so these resistors are used for to maintain the operating point stable. So here it is, I am connecting the output. Okay, why here it is? Output is 180 degrees phase shift in CE amplifier. Why 180 degrees phase shift means? So here I am taking the output voltage is V0 here. So V0 equal to. So here I am taking this one. So here RC means, so this current is IC. So V0 equal to VCC minus IC into RC. Output voltage equal to V0 equal to VCC minus IC into RC. So here, if increases the base means, one formula is there, IC equal to beta IB. Okay? Collector current equal to the beta times of IB. If base current increases, automatically IC is also increases. Why? Because beta times multiplied with IB, IC increases. So here base increases means automatically here IC increases beta time. Whenever IC increases, output voltage V0 is decreases. Why? Because VCC means, so this is constant. For example, here VCC equal to 12 volts. Okay, first initially VCC equal to 12 volts. If it is previously here IC equal to, for example here 5 volts, okay, or resistance equal to 1 kilo ohm or something you can assume. So 12 minus 5 equal to how much means output voltage is 7 volts. Okay, 7 volts. So here IC increases means, for example my IC is increasing to 11. Okay, whenever IC increases means output voltage is decreases. Output voltage is decreases. 12 minus 11 equal to only 1 volt only. So here it is decreases. When here IB increases means, automatically what is output voltage? My IC is decreases. So here, that's why here this is 180 degrees phase shift in common emitter amplifier. So why 180 degrees phase shift means? So here V0 equal to the VCC minus IC into RC. So in this way, so the output voltage is 180 degrees phase shift in common emitter amplifier. So next to amplifier is, next here negative, so same phase reversal. Previously how it is decreases means, so in the negative up cycle, so again here that will be increases. In the base it is decreases means IC is also decreases. When IC decreases means automatically V0 is increases. So that's why here this is 180 degrees phase shift in CE amplifier. So this is 180 degrees phase shift in common emitter amplifier. So here these are the, so bypass capacitor and coupling capacitor and blocking capacitor to block the DC, it allows only AC. So this is the common emitter amplifier. So next amplifier is, next amplifier is emitter follower or common collector amplifier. So which one is